हेलो, इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस अबाउट फॉरवर्ड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट, मीनिंग ऑफ फॉरवर्ड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एंड वी ऑल्सो अंडरस्टूड विथ वन एग्जाम्पल एंड वी ऑल्सो डिस्कस फीचर्स ऑफ फॉरवर्ड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट। नाउ इन टुडे सेशन विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट हाउ फॉरवर्ड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट कैन बी सेटल्ड। वंस इफ एनी वन इज एंटर्ड इन टू अ फॉरवर्ड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट, how forward contract can be settled down. So the forward contract settlement, there are two ways of settling the forward contract. Number one, before discussing this, let us again just have a quick view on forward contract. It is a tailor-made contract between two parties or buying and selling a specified commodity on a specified date at a predetermined price. Now, why it is a tailor-made contract? Because both the parties can enter into contract of buying and selling of any commodity which they want. For example, if I am entering into buying 100 watches, that means I am long on forward, and the other party who promises to sell me 100 watches, then he is said to be short forward. Now, if the watches are available in stock exchange, if the watches contract of watch are available on stock exchange, then it is a futures contract. But as we all know, futures contract, that is in under NSE, the contract are available for only specified commodity like wheat, rice, pulses, sugar, Jira and some selected stocks. So that is why a forward contract is a tailor-made contract. I can enter into promise of buying and selling of any commodity. So let us say the contract has been done. That has been done between two parties. Now how it will be settled? So the first is by actually delivering the asset and making the payment. That is first. So if, for example, exporter sold 10,000 euros to a bank in a 6 month forward contract at 66 rupees. So what is this contract? I'm exporter. I'm supposed to receive 10,000 euros after 6 months. So today I will enter with bank a contract to sell 10,000 euros after 6 months. Now why it is a tailor-made? Euros are available. But suppose the lot size are not fixed. The lot size which futures are available, I am not having the same lot size. Let's say if I am entering into futures contract, minimum 20,000 euros are necessary, but I want only 10,000 euros to sell, and that is why it is said to be forward contract, tailor made. So how it can be settled? So today I am entering into contract to sell 10,000 euros after 6 months at 66 rupees per euro. After 6 months, actually I will give this 10,000 euros to bank, and bank will pay me 10,000 multiplied by 66, that is 6,60,000, and the contract will be over. So contract is settled. So number one, by actually fulfilling the obligation, if I am seller, I will sell, bank is buyer, so bank will definitely buy. So that is why it is known as a delivery by actually giving asset and receiving the consideration. Or number two, the settlement of forward contract can also be done by entering into offsetting contract. Now the meaning of offsetting contract is, initially I was seller, right? I was entering into promise with a bank that I will sell 10,000 euros at 66 rupees. So I am short on forward, bank is long on forward. But suppose anyhow, now I am not interested in selling. So what I will do, initially I was short forward, now I will enter into long forward. Matlab, I will enter into reverse transaction. If I am short, I will enter into long and I am out of the market. Suppose I am long forward, if I want to remove from the forward market, either I have to actually buy or I enter into reverse transaction. Initially, if I am long, I'll enter into short forward, and the contract is settled. So this is how the settlement can be done. Number one, by actually fulfilling the obligation. If you are buyer, you actually buy. If you are seller, you actually sell. Or by entering into offsetting transaction. If you are buyer, long forward initially, and if you actually don't want to buy, enter into short forward, reverse transaction. If you are initially short forward, if you don't want to sell, again enter with long forward, and that is called offsetting transaction, and the contract will be over. Right, so this is what the settlement is. Now in next slide, we'll be discussing about purpose of forward contract, why forward contract is necessary. Purpose of forward contract. If a forward contract could result in loss, why somebody is entering into contract? For example, if we lock the price, a forward contract, I have locked the price to sell 10,000 euros at 66 rupees after 6 months. Now suppose after 6 months, price become 68, but still I will receive only 66 from bank. So in that case, I am having loss of 2 rupees. Right. So for example, if we continue with the previous example, today I am entering into contract with bank that I will supply 10,000 euros after 6 months, and today I agree with bank that I will accept 66 rupees per euro and I will give you 10,000 euro. Now after 6 months, suppose the price between rupees and euro has changed. Rupees and euro after 6 months become 68. So suppose if I am not entered into contract and if I am selling in cash market, I could receive 68 rupees per euro, and if I deliver 10,000, I could receive 6,80,000. But just because I have entered into forward contract, anyhow I have to supply 10,000 to bank at 66. That means 2 rupees I will not get extra. Though the price is 68 in cash market, still I will receive only 66 because I have promised bank that I will give you at 66. Then what is the purpose? Why somebody would accept loss? The main reason of forward contract is not to gain profit. The main reason of entering into forward contract is to avoid uncertainty. Right? The major purpose of entering into forward contract is to avoid price uncertainty and fixing the price. That is called locking the price. Now this is what one scenario we have seen. Suppose price is 68, so I am having loss. But suppose reverse situation can also be possible. If price is 60, then also I could receive 66 rupees from bank because I entered into forward contract. So the benefit of forward contract is whatever the price after 6 months, I have locked my price, I will definitely receive 66. Even though price is 50, still I will receive 66 from bank. And even though price is 70, still I will receive only 66 from bank. So I have removed price uncertainty. Whatever the price will be after 6 months, I do not have to worry. If price falls, then also I'll receive 66. If price rises, then also I'll receive only 66. So I am removing the uncertainty, and that is what the purpose of forward contract, to remove uncertainty. While the strategy may result into loss and gain depending upon the movement of the market. So my main purpose is only to remove uncertainty. In future, price can be from 66 to 68, then I'll be having loss. And in future, price can be from 66 to 60, then also I'll receive 66. That means in that case, I'll be having profit, I'll be having gain. So that is what the purpose. If somebody is having question like what is the purpose of entering into forward contract, it is only and only to remove uncertainty of price, number one, and number two, to remove uncertainty of availability of product. I will definitely able to sell. I have already found someone who can buy from me 10,000 euros, so I don't have to worry about purchaser from my side. I have received my purchaser, bank will definitely buy. Fine. In next slide, we will discussing about advantages of forward contract. Okay, so in this slide, we will be discussing about advantages of forward contract. So what are the benefits? a forward contract. First, the forward contracts are very much flexible in nature. So if we compare forward with futures, futures are exchange traded. You have to deal whatever exchange is saying in the same quantity with the same date. But as far as a forward contract is concerned, it is always tailor-made. You can buy and sell the quantity whatever you want, the date whatever you want, and the quantity whatever you want. So that is what the advantage of, first advantage of forward contract. It is tailor-made and it removes the price uncertainty. Right, number two, further, since the forward contract are agreement between the two party, they are always flexible with respect to amount, quality. Yes, as far as futures contracts are concerned, the qualities are also fixed by exchange. You have to deliver only the desired quality. But in case of forward contract, as it is a contract between two parties, sometimes quality variations are also allowed. Date variations are also allowed, and that is why it is known as a tailor-made contract, and that is called the third advantage. The contract can be tailored. For example, if you have entered initially right now, if you have entered into contract of buying 1000 kg of apple, right, and which is of specified quantity, now on the last day we may alter the quantity. We may say we will be buying only 900 kgs, or we may buy 1100 kgs, depending upon the flexibility of both the parties. So it is always tailor-made. It can be always altered. It can change with the agreement of both the parties. So these are the advantages of forward contract. But if there are advantages, there are also limitations of forward contract. Let us discuss what are the limitations, or you can say demerits of forward contract in the next slide. So in this slide, we'll discuss problems with the forward contract. As we all know, the forward contract are tailor-made. It is not having any authorizing body. It is contract between two parties based on mutual trust. These are the characteristics which we have learned. Now, whatever the benefits of forward contract, there are limitations also. Number one, parties with the matching need. See, it's very difficult to find out party. It is very difficult to find out the counterparty. If I want to buy something, right, I should be having a person who is ready to sell the same quality or same quantity which I want. So it's very difficult to find out parties with the matching need. For example, I want to buy 100 kg of Shrikhand and date is 27th. Now, there are so many people who are ready to sell Shrikhand, but the 27th date may not be available. Maybe the counterparty, the seller, is not able to provide me on 27. And if it is, they are able to provide me on 27, maybe the quality I have to change. I want mango Shrikhand, but they are ready to supply Kesar Shrikhand, etc. So, number one limitation is parties with the matching needs. If you can find, it is very good. You can definitely enter, but it's generally difficult. And number two, non-performance. As it is not under exchange, stock exchange, if the counterparty does not fulfill the obligation, you cannot do anything. For example, if I'm buyer of a Shrikhand and you are seller on 27th, if on 27th I am not turning up to buy, that means from my side, I'm not performing my contract of buying. Then the seller cannot do anything, as it is not under stock exchange, and vice versa. If I'm ready to buy but the seller is not able to supply me, I cannot do any legal action on the seller, as it is not under exchange. It is based on mutual trust. So these are the limitations, or you can say problems of forward contract. Fine.